Jesus came to fruition through a human being in the third dimension. Let's say God lives in the fourth dimension and his kingdom is of a different realm, right? When he talks to Pilate, if we take that into consideration, it's just so mind-boggling. If you do live in the fourth dimension, you can alter the third dimension. The possibilities, because we as Christians believe in God being all-knowing, all-possible. And if everything's possible within God, then that means God can alter the third dimension because he does live outside of the dimension.
That would explain a lot of the paradoxes and a lot of the miracles that our human brains can't understand. Because our third dimension, as we perceive it, has limitations. And of course, God could turn water into wine or see the future, right? Because he's outside time itself. So of course, you're going to see the future or like the other miracles, right? Or even creating the world, creating a universe. Yeah. He's outside the third dimension. He's controlling the third, or maybe being outside the fourth dimension, being a fifth dimensional being, gives him control over the third dimension. If God can see everything, like a fourth dimensional or fifth dimensional being, wouldn't they be able to see through 3D objects? You know, like we can see through this because their perception is beyond our understanding. Because on a map, you can see everything at once. So if you're seeing every 3D object at once as a fifth dimensional being, you should be able to see through the objects, right? Because we can see through everything on a map, right? So you should be
and
able
even to communicate to third dimensional beings.
Yeah, communicates with prayer and confession or thoughts. It says in the Bible that God can read our thoughts or hear our thoughts, right?
Yeah, nothing can be kept away from God. Yeah.
If you can see through 3D objects, you can see through our brain and see the neurons firing at certain patterns. And if he created us, then he knows the exact neuron firings that create specific thought. Translate it like we translate anything. Like code on a computer can be translated into, you know, he can understand what that means and he knows what we're thinking. When you follow that logical, you know, it's crazy. Yeah. Jesus did say, like when Pilate asked him, like, where is your kingdom? And Jesus could have said anything, but he said, my kingdom is not of this realm. I just think that's interesting because it says a dimension, within a dimension, you have realms. So like, is he saying,
A dimension is a level of consciousness.
Yeah, is a higher dimension. Is he saying his kingdom is of a higher dimension? I mean, you can't. Yeah. I mean, it's just there. It's right there in front of you, and he can't say it in scientific terms like we said earlier because no one at that science didn't even exist back then. He can't just start spitting out scientific terms. No one's gonna understand. And why would he? Jesus is not there to confuse people.
Two-dimensional beings can see linear space. Third dimensional beings can see linear time. A dimension is a level of consciousness. So our consciousness that we have at our disposition can only perceive, you know, a certain amount of conscious reality. When we connect to a greater conscience or God, we can almost perceive their reality in the fourth or fifth or whatever dimension.
Yeah, hardcore
in the realm.
Like when they asked him, well, where is heaven, you know? And he said, heaven is here, everywhere around you. And it's like, what does that mean? It's like, what does that mean? Like, how, even metaphorically, right? But if we really are in a fourth dimension, then yeah, that we are engulfed and embedded in a fourth dimension. So it's time is everywhere. You can't really say it's here or there. It's everywhere around us. And if God is outside the fourth dimension, then heaven is outside the fourth dimension, then yeah, I mean, it's everywhere.
Yeah, like you were saying that in a near-death experience, somebody said that the corner of a room when they were, I guess, transcending into the afterlife, the corner of a room started changing geometrically, right? To shapes, I'm sure that we haven't been able to perceive.
Can never
understand. Yeah. They got ready and went to a different dimension. Yeah. And it's like, how is it that, you know, in their deathbed or, you know, in the hospital, wherever they were able to just easily go into a different dimension out of nowhere?
It actually happens or something. It's like your consciousness has to leave the three dimensional body almost to even perceive something like that. DMT is like LSD. It's a hallucinogen. And they say it takes them to these higher levels of, pushes them to higher dimensions. That's not the same as near-death experience. As a matter of fact, it's not even close. But people still feel like they're going to a higher dimension, which I think that in itself is fascinating. Like, can this chemical make you somehow, your consciousness transcend reality? I don't know. But it's different from near-death experiences because it doesn't have the same key elements and they're very inconsistent. All the DMT reports, very inconsistent. Near-death experiences, the craziest thing about those is consistent across the board. Like thousands and thousands of ones that have been statistically analyzed, and many of them have been, these studies have been published in scientific journals and peer-reviewed. Like, this isn't just like books published by Christian authors. This is scientists, doctors publishing this stuff in scientific journals, and they peer-reviewed and still approved them, despite having a what you would think would be a bias against it. But yeah, I wanted to add to that story that I told you about. You just mentioned the geometry changing in the corner of the room when they're having a near-death experience. Like, from what I remember, they said they couldn't even describe the geometric forms and changes that were happening. It was just beyond their comprehension. Like, they can't describe it in human words. And they say when they get there, the colors are beyond anything of this earth. Like, you can't even describe. There's not even a single combination of words that could describe the colors.
Maybe our spiritual self can connect to those different dimensions. No. For a lot of people, it might seem like fairy tale like or unrealistic.
Well, yeah, if you only look at the surface of the Bible, that's how it's going to seem. But when you look, it seems like as if the deeper that I've dug and the more I've applied science to it to try to understand what it really means, the more I find it's more complicated than it seems. And it's actually gets farther away from that fairy tale mindset.